I did all in all either 4 or 5 movies with Phil, and enjoyed them very much, and admire him, and think that he is an excellent director, and that of the 70s directors, he doesn't get as much credit as he deserves. And I, for whatever reason. But I'm very proud of Wanderers and Invasion of the Body Snatchers and White Dawn. Very, very proud of them. I think they are excellent movies. And I happen to have seen them just recently. As I may have mentioned that I supervised the transfer to DVD of White Dawn, and that there was a kind of collection of Phil's movies shown just recently, and I saw, and they wanted me to come and be on a panel and everything, and I saw The Wanderers again. I didn't see Invasion of the Body Snatchers, but I happened to have seen that fairly recently on a DVD. They're great fun, you know? They're wonderful fun. They are deliberately, as I think I said, in a sense, B-movies, in that they are don't have enormous budgets, and they don't have enormous stars, or they had perfect, I mean, they had Donald Sutherland and people in Invasion of the Body Snatchers. And Captain, you know, with the ears, what's his name? They were movies that were very specifically about a subject and treated that subject intelligently and for fun. And they were, in the good sense, B-movies. And Invasion of the Body Snatchers couldn't have the kind of zeitgeist down that the original one had. I remember seeing the original one on the Nemo Theater on 110th Street and Broadway, and it was clear right away that most of the people I knew were pods, and that this was about the 50s, and it had McCarthyism and the conformity of the 50s, and it had it all as an unconscious material. Talk about, my God. So it was wonderful, and then we couldn't, in the 70s, have anything that was quite so nailed down as that. But it's a pretty good and charming and funny movie. It goes on, it has maybe one too many climaxes and things, but there's a lot of wonderful fun in it, you know, the fun of movie making and the fun of, and I'm in it, I'm a pod in it. The whole San Francisco film community wanted to be in it because there was a lot of, straining to be a pod. I want to be a pod, but we were very careful who we let be pods, and I got to be a pod. I was a night watchman in the Department of Health, where they sneak back and they come around a corner, and there's a night watchman who's mopping with his mop, and he looks like that, and I'm a pod, and Tom Luddy from the Pacific Film Archives is a pod, and Bobby Duvall, who had worked with Phil on a movie years ago, happened to be in San Francisco, so we threw him in as a pod. He's dressed as a priest, and he's swinging on a swing, and he's a pod. There was a lot of competition to be pods. We all wanted to be, and it's great fun, and it has. It has the 70s kind of down, you know, sort of 70s San Francisco scene where it's hard to know whether someone is a pod or whether they're just a sort of, you know, 70s asshole. And what's his name is a psychiatrist, and you can't know whether, you know, for a long while, you don't know whether he's really a pod or he's just a psychiatrist. And it turns out he's both. Oh, you know, Captain from space, from, help me.
Leonard Nimoy,
thank you. Yes, you don't know whether Leonard Nimoy is a pod or a psychiatrist, and it turns out he's both. And he's wonderful as a pod and a psychiatrist. It was a lot of fun, that movie. And Jeff Goldblum is a silly poet and things. Oh, it has just fun and I did whatever occurred to me to do, you know, to hype things up. At one point, we shot a whole scene with a 16mm lens as though it was the pod's point of view and things. And all we did anything we could think of to be outrageous, because we knew we couldn't be as brilliantly on point as the first one was, because the political and social situation wasn't the same. So we just said, what the hell, we'll have fun. And I think we did have fun. And it was fun to do because of that, because we felt really quite free to enjoy ourselves and make outrageous stuff and hang the camera upside down, have the camera come this way and turn that way and be on a bungee cord and do anything we wanted and have huge shadows preceding people running through the night and stuff. We did whatever amused us and felt quite free to. And there are some sequences in it that are really quite fun, really quite, quite fun. There's a long sequence that I shot handheld that I challenge you to tell whether it was a Steadicam or handheld. I mean, it's really, I'm really quite proud of that. I show that every once in a while. It follows Donald and and Brooke Adams down or thing, and they're arguing and they talk, and the camera goes here and goes there and goes around with them for a long, whole long sequence in one take. And it looks as if it's a Steadicam, but they didn't have Steadicam. And I did it handheld. And it was, we had a great deal of fun doing it. And it doesn't add up to anything like the first one, but it has a nice paranoid, it has moments of real wonderful paranoia to it. And it was fun to do.